everybody. How y'all doing? I just coming to y'all in y'all homes today to talk to you again about faith, obedience, and what else? And we talked about grace. So those are the three things we're going to go back and reiterate all over again. Some things have been happening in my life, and I'm so excited, God. I just want to share that with y'all. I want to share with y'all what's been going on, because God is doing something in the Holy Spirit. Me and my friend, we went walking the other day. I tell you, God showed up and showed out. He told us to go walking in the park and begin to pray and speak some things into the atmosphere. And he told us when we begin to speak some things into the atmosphere that he was going to do it, that he was going to make a way out of no way. And even right now, I can feel that the Spirit of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is even in your homes right now. I'm about to bring this sermon to the head, to the course today. In the name of Jesus, I just want you to get excited about what God is doing in the Spirit. I'm so excited. I don't even know what he's going to do from one day to the next. I'm just so excited about what God is getting ready to do. Even when I'm sleeping at night, I'm in my bed, laying down, and even God began to reiterate with me. He began to talk to me. He began to speak to me. He began to speak through me. And I just want to reiterate that today. And even on today, God gave me what to pray for. He told me to pray in our books, Genesis chapter 6-9. That's what he gave me. And he always give me things at the very last minute. So y'all just pray with me that I'm going to bring this word to fruition. I'm going to bring it to pass. I just want you to just get excited about what he's doing, about what God is doing in the spirit realm. God is doing something in the spirit realm. I don't know what he's doing, but God is doing something great. He's doing something big. He's doing something huge. So I want y'all to get ready. Get ready, get ready. Get ready, get ready. Tell your neighbor, get ready, get ready, get ready. Get ready, because he's showing up and showing out in our life today. And I just want you to go with me to Genesis chapter 6. Go with me to verse 14. I'm going to be skipping over all these verses, and then I'm going to bring it to you so you can see it and understand what God is doing. He's doing something while you're sleeping at night. Even while you're asleep, guys, he's doing something. Begin to pray with me right now. God, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. We forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever, God. And we just thank you even right now on this day. Thank you, Lord God. In Jesus' name, Lord God, I pray, amen, and thank God. Go with me to Genesis chapter 6, verse 14 through verses 17. Verse 14 says, Make thee an ark of gopher wood. Room shall thou make in the ark, and shall pitch it within and without with pitch. Verse 15, and this is the fashion which thou shalt make it of. The length of the ark shall be 300 cubits, the breadth of it 50 cubits, and the height of it 30 cubits. I'm sorry. Verse 16, a window shall thou make to the ark, and in a cubit shall thou finish it. Above in the door of the ark shall lower second and third stories shall thou make it. Verse 17, and behold, I do bring a flood of waters upon the earth to destroy all flesh, where is the breath of life from under heaven, and everything that is the earth shall die. Go to chapter 6, verse 8. Says, but Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Go with me to chapter 7, verse 11. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, the 17th day of the month, the same day were all the fountains of the great deep broken up, and the windows of heaven were opened. Oh my God. Go with me to chapter 8, chapter 8, verse 2. The fountains also did the deep, and the windows of heaven were stopped, and the rain from heaven were restrained. Go with me to chapter 9, verse 1. And God blessed Noah and his sons, and said unto them, be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth. Chapter 9, verse 11 says, and I will establish my covenant with you, neither shall all flesh be cut of any more by the waters of a flood, neither shall there any more be a flood to destroy the earth. My God. God said he would not flood the earth ever again. Hallelujah, Jesus. I just want you to know what I just read. Genesis chapter 6 through 9. I just went to a couple of verses so you can see how God is working and what God is doing and how God is reiterating that to what I'm about to tell you that God is doing, even right now in the spirit. We began to talk about in chapter 6, we were talking about how God showed Noah the steps of how to make an ark. Now that you're walking in obedience, God is showing you step by step by step on how to do things, on how to orchestrate where he's getting ready to take you. There are some things in your life that you asked God to do, maybe not recently, but maybe a while back where you asked God to do something. And now God is reiterating how to do those steps, how to re-enter those steps and do them the way that he's orchestrating. Oh, he's putting things in order right now. In order. He's putting things in order right now. You hear me? He's putting things in order. Order. He's putting things in order. Order. Order in your house. Order in your steps. Order in the way you do things in the name of Jesus. Order. He's bringing order to it. He even told Noah how to do things step by step. By step, by step. He's telling you how to do things step by step. In doing it, he's allowing you to be able to follow direction and be obedient to it. Not when you want to do it, but when God tells you to do it. It was necessary that Noah built that ark at the time that God told him to do it. It's necessary that you be obedient to God's will, that when God tells you to do something, that you do it right now. Not on your time, but on God's time. Not your will, but you allow God's will to do what he needs to do in your life. I always tell God when I begin to pray that, God, I don't want what I want for my life. I want what you want for my life, God. Because what I want may not be lining up with what you need to be doing in my life and for me. But God knows, because I'm his child. Even in the verse where I said, I talked about, but Noah found grace in the eyes of God. Remember, we already talked about grace and how grace works and what we do to get to the point of using grace in our life. Grace, I'm going to go back and tell you what grace is. Grace is used when when you can't do it on your own, when you can't do it for yourself. That's what grace is. And how to use grace is, even when I begin to pray, I begin to pray even for myself. I begin to pray, God, give me the grace to be able to preach. Give me the grace, God, to be able to have the knowledge to speak a word into somebody's life, that it may change somebody, God. I can't do it, God, but you can. You give me the grace, God, to be able to do it in the name of Jesus, God. Even when I'm praying for my husband, I say, God, give my husband the grace, God, to obey you. In the name of Jesus, God, give him the grace to be able to humble himself before you, God. These are things, God, that I know he can't do for himself. But God, through your grace and through your mercy, God, he can do it. He can do it. We can't do this thing by ourselves, God, but with you, God, all things are possible. All things are made possible, God. In the name of Jesus, I thank you right now, God, for everything that you're doing, everything, God, that you are putting before me, even right now. Even in the Bible, where it says how God took the water, you know, when he was on the boat, when Noah was on the boat on the ark, how he began to replenish the earth, you know, replenish the earth with the water. God destroyed many things. He destroyed lots of things. And even within ourselves, God is doing it. He's replenishing us. Yeah, when you walk in obedience, God is replenishing you. God is doing things over. He's making you over. He's taking some things out. He's putting some things in. Hallelujah, Jesus. All the things that shouldn't be there, God is removing them. Even right now, he's removing things that shouldn't be there. He's taking things out. Hallelujah, Jesus. He's making you over. He's creating you and making you all brand new. Hallelujah, Jesus. I know he's creating me over. I know he's making me new. Hallelujah. I can feel it in the spirit realm that I'm not the same. And when you begin to walk in obedience, you will feel that God is replenishing you. He's taking some things out. He's putting some things in. I ain't talking about the things that you used to do. You ain't doing no more. You passed that. I'm talking about the things that he's doing in the spirit right now. That you don't even know he's doing. Because when you begin to be obedient and walk in God and begin to pray in tongues because you don't know what you're praying about. I don't know who that is to take care of that. I don't know who that is to take care of. I was praying the other night, and then I was praying in the spirit. I was praying for some things, and then I was praying in the spirit as well. We don't know what we're praying when we pray in the spirit. I woke up the next day, and some things began to happen. Because I began to do the things that God was telling me to do. I'm going somewhere with this. I was recently in Nebraska. I was doing nursing. You know, the things that I want to do. But there's a time, there's a place, and there's things that God wants us to do. And if we're not in position to do it, sometimes God will force our hand. He'll force us to do it. In the name of Jesus, God forced me. He forced me to come back to Memphis. I was in Nebraska. I was doing what I wanted to do. I wanted to do travel nursing. There was something that I always wanted to do. But when you got a calling on your life, God will separate you from where you're, you know, from. He will separate you. Hallelujah, that's what he did to me. He brought me back to Memphis. God said, I need you to come back to Memphis. I need you to come back to Memphis. I already knew that he was going to rearrange my schedule and rearrange me. But that's when God began to put things in order. He will force you to obey him, okay? He will force you to obey him. I don't know what I was praying for, but God had me on a fast, praying and fasting for my husband. Had it over there. They said, take care. And doing that, I said, Lord, look at God. Every time I go to a patient's room or I begin to go to an assignment that I had signed up for on this app, you know, that I was working from in Nebraska. Everywhere I went, it seemed like I was getting attacked. I was praying and fasting. Do you hear me? For my husband. In the name of Jesus. I was doing what God had told me to do, to fast and pray. Hallelujah. And in fasting and praying, God began to bless me and God began to rearrange my schedule and do what he wanted me to do. Think about it. When Noah was building his ark, if he hadn't been at the right place at the right time and doing what God had told him to do and then he obeyed God, people would have been at stake. Same situation with me. If I hadn't have done what the Lord had told me to do to come back here. I have people who are assigned to me. You have people who are assigned to you that you are responsible for. That you have to get them to a place that God told you to get them to in the name of Jesus. And I'm hoping even right now somebody is blessed with this message that I am speaking right now into their life. Because God is going to not only bless you, but he's going to bless your household. Oh, glory to God. God was dealing with me. He was dealing with me. I mean, every person room that I was going to, it was just a disaster. It was God had just created a disaster. And sometimes it ain't the devil. Mm-mm. It was God pushing me back to this place, the place in which I was supposed to be in the name of Jesus. I wasn't supposed to be there that long. Hallelujah. There are people that need you. And you need to be at that place where they can be able to reach out and touch you. And sometimes people can't deal with you being away from the situation so long. But God began to tell me, go back. It's time for you to pack up and go back to Memphis. I didn't hesitate when he told me. I went on back. And God is just, he's doing some things. And he's doing some things. He's doing some things. So getting ready, because God is doing some things even in the spirit. Remember, we're walking by faith and not by sight. So we don't know what God is doing in the spirit realm. But all we need to do is just trust him.
trust God with everything I have. In the name of Jesus, I ask God, I say, God, help me because I can't help myself. God, give me the grace to be able to trust you. Give me the grace, God, to be able to walk in your grace in the name of Jesus. And that's what I'm walking in right now. I'm walking in his grace. But God will, he will push you to a place to bless you. And that's what he did for me. When I came back here, I walked into, because you're getting ready to walk into some things. I walked into my blessings. God forced me to come back here so that I would not miss my blessing. That's how much he loved you. That's how much God loves you. And even in the Bible, when Noah began to build that ark, I just believe that everybody that was on that boat, they were the different things of people. Think about it. It had to be some people on there that was unbelievers. There had to be some people of other Christianity. And I'm sure there were people on there that didn't even believe in God, period, that Noah was assigned to. And all those people, God covered them. And even right now, God is covering you. He's covering you in his blood. Because once you begin to walk in obedience, God covers you. He covers you in every area. Anything that's coming towards you that shouldn't, God block it. He's covering you. He's making sure that you are being made whole. Hallelujah. And even God told one of my closest friends, we began to walk because God had us walking and praying. Those were one of the things that God had us doing. And he told us restitution. So God is telling you restitution right now. That means the things that were taken from you, that were stolen from you, that was lost. God is now being able, God is now giving it back to you. The things that were lost, God is now, he's giving them back to you. Oh, I'm just so excited about what God is doing in the spirit realm. Hallelujah, Jesus. I don't know what he's doing or what he's about to do. But God want to do something great. But not only that, he told me, he says, I want you to come back because you're working too hard. He said, come back. I want you to do ministry. I want you to do ministry more. I want you to do ministry. Think about doing ministry full time. He said, I want to take care of you. That's what God told me. I want to take care of you. He told me don't depend on man. God told me to depend on him. That he's going to take care of every need according to his riches and glory. He's going to take care of me. Hallelujah, Jesus. When God tell you that he's going to do something for you, that he want to do something great for you, that's incredible. That is remarkable. And I thank God right now, because right now I'm walking in my calling. You got to know what you're being called to. You got to know what calling is on your life. So you will know without a shadow of a doubt that you're doing what God has told you to do. All you got to do is obey God. That's all God wants you to do, is obey him. Hallelujah, Jesus. And he'll take care of the rest. Oh, glory to God. I'm just so excited. So excited about what God is doing, even in my life right now. Hallelujah, Jesus. I'm so excited. I'm so excited about God. Thank you, Lord. I thank you right now, God, for being who you are in my life right now. And even when God told me to come back, my girlfriend, she had already, she's a prophet. She had already told me, she said, God's going to reorchestrate your situation. She said, you're going to go for one thing, but God's going to send you back. And I tell you what, every time she speaks something or says something, it always happens. Hallelujah, Jesus. But be open to what God is doing right now. Be susceptible to what he's doing, because he's calling the people to obey him right now, to get into position where you can be blessed, but not only you being blessed, but your household to be blessed. Because when the blessings are on you, they're going to fall on God's people. Hallelujah. And Joseph is a witness to that, how he was blessed and how God blessed him. He got blessed. And when he began to get blessed, oh my God, his family got blessed. It just poured over into his family. Hallelujah. Joseph was one of the ones who obeyed God. Think about the ones in the battle that obeyed God. Joseph was one that obeyed God. Daniel was one that obeyed God. The Proverbs 31 woman was one that obeyed God and got blessed. Her whole household was blessed. I don't know what it is. Say, Kennedy, how did I hope that this thing take you? I'm just excited. I'm overwhelmed. I'm grateful. I'm honored, God, that you have chose me, God, to do your will, to do your work. Hallelujah, Jesus. And I'll do whatever it takes to obey God. You got to get to a place where you said, no matter what it takes, I'm going to obey God. I don't know who it is. He told me to put him first. And everything shall be added unto me. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. I thank him. Hallelujah. For everything that he's done for me in my life. You got to get to a place where you surrender all your will unto God. And you say, God, here I am. God, and I'm willing and ready to do whatever it takes to do what you have orchestrated me to do in my life. For your people, God. Not my will, but allow your will, God, to be done in me. In the name of Jesus. Because I'm just only a vessel that God is using for his glory. And I stand in the gap and intercede for people that need me. People with cancer, people with all kinds of diseases. I pray for them, me and my girlfriend. We get on the battlefield for them and intercede and pray. You got to know what you are called to so that God can bless you. And not only you, but bless your whole household. And I thank him every morning when I get up. I'm thanking him. Thank you, God, for everything that you're doing in my life. Thank you for what you're even doing right now, God, in the name of Jesus. You got to get to a place where God is your source. God is my source. I don't know what it is to take care of. Thank you right now, God. In Jesus' name, Lord God, I pray. Amen and thank God. Hallelujah. I want y'all to join me back on next month when I preach about something else that's coming up that God has given me. But just keep following me. Follow me on Facebook. Follow me. Even if you want to sow into me, my is $Yolanda1969. If you would like to sow into me, Cash App. Thank you so much, and I'll see you back next time.
Let me hear the worshipers. Where's all of my praises? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go. It's who I got. Every word of worship. With one accord. Every praise is to our God.